Inevitable. If you're in the front, you're going to be wearing this target on your back. But that's okay, because that means that you're in the front. The haters are always behind you. You can't have a target on your back, right? If the haters are in front of you, you're doing the right thing. Keep that up, okay? Don't worry about the haters. Keep going. As a fire service, we need to stop blaming our problems and stuff on others. We need to take ownership and accountability. We need to stop externalizing blame, rather internalize responsibility. That's how we grow. Get involved with your department. It's your department, it's your house, your family. If you want to see change, get involved. Don't ever bitch about something without having an option or a potential solution about it. Get involved. Take the blinders off. You are not the best. I am not the best. My fire department is not the best. Take the blinders off, look to the left, look to the right, and learn. Bring something in from all these departments, adapt it to yours, your staffing, your geographical response, and make it better. Be open-minded. Hold the standard. As a nation, we're lowering the standard now, and it's not okay. When you lower the standard, you lose the winners. When you raise the standards, you lose the losers. And for the chiefs and everybody that has power, hold the standard, man. If your chiefs don't want to hold the standard, then your district chiefs hold the standard. If your district chiefs don't want to hold the standards, I want to freaking hold the standard. And my guys know that, Mike, you know that. Tower 1, we'll hold the fucking standard. Alright? Have micro standard, it's okay. Alright? But bring people up. Bring people up. It's okay to have all this equality stuff, but we need the equality of opportunity, not equality of outcome. We all need to have the chance of having the opportunity, but it's not fair to just give it all across the board. You gotta earn it. This job is not for everybody, okay? And finally, have pride. Pride, man. My boy Dorval had his class A on a second ago. He came in here, he's like, man, I wore my class A because you always wear your class A, and I freaking have pride just like you. Right? That's pride. It costs nothing. It's free. Pride is free. Pride increases happiness. Happiness increases morale. Morale increases productivity. Productivity increases success. And it's fucking free.
That shit's
free. Why not do it? Free.
Right? Shit.
This is my favorite rule in the Orlando Fire Department. I want to read it to you. I got fucking goosebumps. Members of the department are expected to be firm and calm in your actions at all times. And in times of peril, shall act together to protect each other from danger. When a member who shirks from dangers or responsibility, when duty requires that they meet it, shall be deemed unworthy of the place of the Orlando Fire Department. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, yeah. We're holding the standard. If I'm in trouble, I want that fireman to come get me or my kids. That person right there. Effort and attitude are two attributes that are necessary, but you need performance. Do not forget that. You need performance. Remember why we're here in the first place. We're here to serve and protect each other and the public, on and off the job. Don't forget the off the job part, like my man Rick Jordan was talking about. It is huge, and the brotherhood and sisterhood is alive, believe me. People think it's not, it's alive, right? We're here for our families, we're here for our brothers and sisters, you guys, but mainly we're here for them, the people we serve. That lady on the left doesn't care if you're black, white, female, yellow, Chinese, or you identify as a fucking plant. She doesn't care. All she cares about is that you're going to show up to her house and get her kids out of harm's way, get her out, clear that source, put that fire out. That's all she cares about. And that's how we need to be the fire service. Blind to all these criteria. We don't care about that. That fire over the line over there, that's a paramour, it was like a B-shift. Those guys made a push and they were made a grab, right? It's not our job to determine the outcome. Our job is to get in there, do our job, and search it. Maximize the chance of survival. That's what we're here for, okay? And I'll leave you with this. I stole this from John Sparrow, my man with the standard Fit to Fight Fire Online. Under pressure, you don't rise to the occasion. You sink to your level of training. And finally, I know it's very cliche, but look at yourself in the mirror, look at your crew in the mirror, and your department, and answer that question. Would you want you rescuing you or your family? If the answer is no, you have work to do. If the answer is yes, guess what? You still have work to do. Ladies and gentlemen, this is it. I think I followed my mentor, Chief Griffin, step on going overtime. My influence up there. If you want to call me, text me, email me, or shoot the shit anytime in this conference, this is what it's all about. You are the one percenters. When you leave out here, pass it on, and let's make the fire service better.